Thank you for visiting. Make sure to like and subscribe and hit notification bell for more.
Merci de votre visite. Assurez-vous d'aimer et de vous abonner et d'appuyer sur la cloche de notification pour en savoir plus.
Gracias por su visita. Asegúrese de darle me gusta y suscribirse y presione la campana de notificación para obtener más información.
City Hall to remember the fallen since 1919, the first anniversary of the end of the First World War, over 100 years ago. This year, we also commemorate the 70th anniversary of the end of the Korean War, which claimed the lives of 516 Canadians, and at least 38 of them have a connection to Toronto. This year also marks 75 years of Canadian participation in United Nations peacekeeping missions. In time of war, the pursuit for peace has been a historic road for Canada. Over 125,000 Canadians have served and are serving in United Nations peacekeeping at home and around the world. Today, we honor the contributions and remember the 130 Canadians who have died in UN operations, including 8 from Toronto. It was August 9, 1974, when the news broke of the Buffalo Nine. the 9 Canadian peacekeepers who were killed as the aircraft they were in, a Canadian buffalo, was shot down. It was the greatest loss of life in Canadian peacekeeping operations. Among the casualties was Toronto resident Corporal Michael William Simpson. He enlisted in the Canadian Army at age 16 and spent a decade supervising ceasefires and volunteering for deployment to the UN Emergency Force Middle East before losing his life in service at a tender age of 26. Corporal Simpson's mother, Loyola Helen Park, became the first mother of the peacekeeper to receive the National Memorial Cross Mother recognition. Another incredible peacekeeper is that of William.
Music was performed by the Elmer Eisner Singers and the direction of Lydia Adams.